Okay, good morning children. Mineral nutrition continuation. Okay, yesterday class we completed nodule formation. So the last one of the equation, one of the diagram remained. Already equation, you know, nitrogenase enzyme which can convert the atmospheric nitrogen into ammonia. So here you can see, this is the enzyme nitrogenase. This is the enzyme nitrogenase. This is the enzyme nitrogenase. Okay, which can combine with substrate. Here substrate nitrogen gas. Here this is the substrate. This is the substrate nitrogen gas. Okay, so enzyme nitrogenase combined with substrate. Okay, that is here you can see binding of the substrate. Enzyme and substrate both are binding. Here binding of the substrate. Okay, here you can see nani. One reduction division is there. Here you can see clearly. This is the first reduction division. This is the second reduction division. Reduction means gaining of hydrogens. This is the third reduction division. Okay. So reaction means gaining of hydrogens. Here finally end product is released. The end product here, you can two ammonia compounds are released. Here you can see these end products, the end product not here. This is the product. Product is what here? Ammonia. Ammonia is the product here. Ammonia. Okay, finally this reaction releases product. Your product is ammonia, and free enzymes also released. These free enzymes can bind with another substrate. This is the free enzyme. Free enzyme bind with another substrate means another N2. Okay, so this is the reaction. So finally the nitrogenase enzyme combined with substrate N2, the reaction is going on. In that three reduction divisions are there. After that finally product was released. What is the product? Ammonia. And free enzymes also released. These free enzymes again bind with another substrate. So this is the reaction. Okay, you can remember nani. Next, what is ammonia, fate of ammonia? Next topic, important topic. Fate means position. But what is the position? What happened to the ammonia finally? Fate of ammonia. Here one more thing here you can listen. At physiological pH, ammonia is protonated to form ammonium ions. Ammonia means NH3. Ammonium NH4. At physiological pH, ammonia protonated means to add a proton. By adding the proton, ammonia NH3 is converted into NH4 ammonium ions. At physiological pH, ammonia protonated and form ammonium. At physiological pH, ammonia protonated and form ammonium. Here, most of the plants can assimilate nitrates as well as ammonia. Most of the plants, they can absorb nitrates as well as ammonia. But here, now ammonium is a toxic substance. Nitrates, okay. Most of the plants, they can assimilate nitrates and ammonia. Nitrates, okay, that are very useful.
But ammonia is a poisonous substance. These cannot accumulate in the plants. This ammonium, what? How the ammonium is converted? Ammonium is not accumulated in plants. But because ammonium is a poisonous substance. But what happened to the ammonia? But what is the fate of the ammonia? This ammonia is used to convert, synthesize amino acids in plants. By using this ammonia, plants can synthesize amino acids. But because if the plant store ammonia in that form, that is toxic substance, poisonous substance. So by using this ammonia, plants they can convert amino acids. Okay. But how the amino acids are formed? There are two main ways in which these formation of the amino acids are takes place. The first, with the help of the two reactions, amino acids are synthesized. The first one is reductive amination. Okay. The first one is reductive amination. First one is reductive amination. Okay. Second one is transamination. Okay. With the help of these two ways, finally amino acids are synthesized. The first one is reductive amination, second one is transamination. But what is the reductive amination? In this reductive amination, ammonia reacts with alpha keto glutaric acid. Here you can see ammonia reacts with alpha keto glutaric acid. Ammonia react with alpha keto glutaric acid. Here energy source NADPH is there. NADPH. And finally, glutamic acid is one type of amino acid. Glutamic acid is produced. Water vapor also produced. NADP also synthesized. So finally, okay, ammonia combined with alpha keto glutaric acid. Ammonia combined with alpha keto glutaric acid. Finally, glutamic acid is produced. And H2O water molecules are released, and NADP also synthesized. Okay, so this is the reductive amination. Ammonia combined with alpha keto glutaric acid by using the NADPH energy. Finally, glutamic acid is one type of amino acid. Glutamic acid is produced. Water vapor also released. NADPH is reduced to NADP. So this is the reductive amination. But this reaction is carried out with the help of glutamate dehydrogenase enzyme. The enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase is responsible for that reaction. Finally, glutamic acid is synthesized. Glutamic acid is one type of amino acid. So this is about the reductive amination. Ammonia combines with alpha keto glutaric acid in the presence of enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase. Finally, glutamic acid is one type of amino acids are produced. So this is about the production of amino acids by first method, that is reductive amination. But what is the second one? Transamination. Okay, what is the second one? Here you can see transamination, especially it involves transfer of amino group from amino acid to keto group of keto acid. Amino group is there. Keto acid, keto group is there. So amino group is transferred to keto group. Keto group is transferred to amino group. So both are transferred. Amino group of amino acid transferred to keto group of keto acid. Okay. So glutamic acid is the main amino acid here, which transfer of amino group takes place. Another new amino acids are synthesized. This reaction is carried on with help of transaminase enzyme. Here you can see the reaction. Okay, here you can see the reaction clearly, Rani. Here you can see the reaction clearly. Here you can see reaction clearly. Okay, acidic group, amino group, amino group. Okay, so here this is the amino group, and here this is the amino group, amino group. This is the amino acid, this is the glutamic acid, glutamic acid. This is the glutamic acid, this is glutamic acid. Here you can see keto acid. Here you can see keto acid now. This is the keto acid. Okay, so here reaction is going on. Here glutamic acid, this is the keto acid, this is the keto acid. So what is going on here? Amino group from the amino acid. Here amino group from amino acid is transferred to keto group of keto acid. Keto group of keto acid. This is the amino group of amino acid. Glutamic acid is amino acid. Amino group of amino group here. Amino group of amino acid is transferred to keto group. This is the keto group of keto acid. So the reaction you can see now. Clearly, then you can see the reaction. Then you can see the reaction. New amino acids are synthesized here. New amino acids are synthesized. This is the new amino acid. New amino acid. This is the organic acid. Okay, so like this, amino group of amino acid is transferred to keto group of keto acid. Then you can see transfer is going on. So finally, new amino acids are synthesized. Okay, so this reaction is carried with the help of the enzyme transaminase. This reaction is carried out with the help of enzyme transaminase. So this is the second one, transamination. This is the second reaction, transamination. Transamination means amino group of amino acid is transferred to keto group of keto acid. So finally, new amino acids are produced. This reaction is carried out with the help of the enzyme transaminase. Yes, here the two most important amides, aspergine and glutamine. Two important amides. What are the two important amides? There are two important amides are there. One is aspergine and glutamine. Two important amides. Aspergine and glutamine. Aspergine and glutamine. These are the two amino. These are the two amides. These are the two amides. Amides are mainly two types. One is aspergine and second one glutamine. These are present in plants. These are mainly structural part of the proteins. Aspergine and glutamine. These two are the structural parts of the proteins. These are especially found in plants. So these two amides are formed by two amino acids. Aspergine is produced from aspartic acid. Glutamine is produced from glutamic acid. Okay, aspartic acid, glutamic acid. Aspergine is produced from aspartic acid. Glutamine is produced from glutamic acid. Glutamic acid. So these two amides are aspergine and glutamine. These two amides. Aspergine is amide which is produced from aspartic acid. glutamine is amide which is produced from glutamic acid. So here the hydroxyl part of the acid is replaced by another amino radicals. The amides contain more and more nitrogen in their amino acids. Amides contain more and more nitrogen in their amino acids. They are transported to another part of the plant via xylem vessels. Through the xylem vessels only, these amides are transported to other parts of the plant. Why? Because amides contain more and more nitrogen in their amino acids. So they are transported to other parts of the plant via xylem vessels. In addition, in some plants, especially soybean, you can see, along with transpiration stream, the nodules of some plants export fixed nitrogen in the form of urides. Especially in soybean, along with transpiration stream, the nodules of these plants transfer the fixed nitrogen in the form of urides. Just example, soybean. The soybean, especially these urides, these are transported to transpiration stream with help of root nodules. Okay, so these compounds particularly having more nitrogen and carbon content, especially along with the transpiration stream, nodules of soybean plant, they can export fixed nitrogen in the form of urides. They can transport fixed nitrogen in the form of urides through its root nodules in the transpiration stream. So these compounds, urides mainly contain nitrogen and carbon ratio. So this is about the, we can see, Nani, this is about the formation of the amino acids. Okay, the two steps you can remind. But what is the fate of ammonia at physiological pH? Ammonia is protonated to form ammonium. NH3 is converted into NH4. So most of the plants, they can accumulate nitrates as well as ammonia. But ammonia is a toxic substance. So plants, they cannot accumulate the ammonium. So they convert the ammonium by synthesizing amino acids. There are two ways for synthesizing the amino acids. The first one is reductive transamination. In this reductive transamination, ammonia is combined with alpha ketoglutaric acid in the presence of enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase. Finally, glutamic acid is produced. That is reduction amination. Ammonia combined with alpha ketoglutaric acid in the presence of enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase. Finally, glutamic acid is synthesized. That is reductive amination. Transamination. All you know that. Transfer of amino groups from amino acid to keto group of keto acid. This reaction is carried out with the help of enzyme transaminase. In this reaction, new amino acids are synthesized. Okay. Here, this is the amino acid, glutamic acid. This is the keto acid. Here, in this glutamic acid, this is the amino group. In ketoic acid, this is the keto group. So, both amino group and keto group are exchanged. Both amino groups and keto groups are exchanged. Finally, new amino acids are synthesized. So, this, and one more thing here you can remind. Amides are mainly two types. One is aspergine, second one glutamine. Aspergine, glutamine, these are present in plants. These are very useful. These are the structural components of proteins. Aspergine is amide which is produced from aspartic acid. Glutamine is amide which is produced from glutamic acid. These amides contain more and more nitrogen in their amino acids. These are transported through the xylem vessels, especially in some plants, soybean plants. Along with the transpiration stream, root nodules that can transfer fixed nitrogen in the form of urides. These urides contain more and more nitrogen and carbon ratio. So this is the fate of ammonia. So today class we completed second chapter, Nani. Especially this reaction, enzyme substrate reaction. Finally, product are released through free enzyme also released here. This free enzyme ready to bind new substrate. So this reaction is very important. Next, fate of ammonia in that synthesis of amino acid two types, reductive amination, transamination. So these are the topic we discussed. So this is about the second chapter, mineral nutrition. Tomorrow class we are going to start the third chapter, enzymes. Okay, thank you children.